It's an orange juice.
What's up, everyone? This is OJ. We're getting a new balance update this coming week, just in time to nerf the Night Witch. She is way too strong. She currently spawns 2 bats every 5 seconds. They're turning this down a notch. She'll now spawn bats every 6 seconds. On top of the decreased spawn intervals, she will no longer spawn 2 bats immediately after being deployed. There's going to be a slight delay before she spawns those first 2 bats. When she dies, she'll pop 4 bats. They're also nerfing this, so now she'll only spawn 3 bats on death. This is kind of like skeletons. Its DPS is decreasing from 268 to 201. If you look at the Night Witch, there's significant impact on the map. To summon 6 bats, it used to take 10 seconds. With these balance changes, it will now take over 13 seconds to reach this mark. Tornado, poison, and heal mechanics are receiving a buff. The spells will now stack. For example, in the current version, if you mirrored poison on top of itself, it would not stack. Notice how only the last tick of the mirrored poison did damage. With a new mechanic tweak, you can dual cast poison, heal, or tornado on top of each other. It won't cancel itself out. As for the tornado itself, its duration is being reduced from 3 seconds to 2.5 seconds. It's still going to be able to activate the King's Tower for most units, but the most significant change is that since the duration is reduced, so is the damage, from 174 to 145. Tornado no longer takes out stab goblins by itself. This affects goblins, goblin gang, and the goblin barrel. In the last balance update in December, the Log received a nerf. Its range of damage was 11.6 tiles, reduced down to 11.1 tile. This was reversed as soon as they realized there was a bug preventing users from casting it on top of buildings. Offensively, it will still hit the arena tower. Defensively, it will still take out Goblin Barrel and Princess at the Bridge. In this balance update, its range is reducing back down to 11.1. If you can cast it on top of buildings again, I feel like this is a buff because you can use the log to protect your siege buildings better. Another advantage to being able to cast the log on top of buildings is that you can protect your Elixir Pump from a Goblin Barrel planted in the corner. The Goblin Gang is one of the best defensive cards in the game. It can defend against most ground units and a lot of air units. It's receiving a nerf. They're removing 1 spear goblin, so the gang will now spawn 3 stab goblins and 2 spear goblins. When the skeletons were rebuffed to include 4 skeletons, it provided too much value. Shutting down a musketeer and electro wizard completely, they offer far too much utility for 1 elixir. They're removing that 1 duet. This decreases their DPS from 268 to 201. The bandit is receiving a buff. She's going to dash faster. Her dash charge time currently takes 1 second to initiate. Her new dash charge time will be slightly faster. This means you're going to have to react a bit faster to prevent her from connecting to your tower. On top of this dash buff, she's receiving a health boost, increasing from 750 to 780. The Dark Prince will now take 5 swings to kill her, and she'll survive 1 extra shot from minions, archers, and spear goblins. The Inferno Dragon, but not Sparky, is receiving a buff too. Its health is increasing by 7%. It's going to go up from 1000 to 1070. This is higher than a baby dragon. It's now able to tank 1 extra shot from archers, minions, witch, musketeer, baby dragon, spear goblins, ice wizard, lava pup, electro wizard, mega minion, and the dart goblin. This seems like a lot, but these are one-on-one interactions. With the princess tower assisting, there shouldn't be too much of a noticeable difference. The biggest buff of all is that its load time is decreasing from 1.2 seconds to 1 second. This means that it'll retarget smaller units slightly faster, so skeletons won't be able to counter it as hard. The original witch is getting a significant change. Her splash attack radius is increasing from 1 tile to 1.1 tiles. This is a very subtle buff, but increases her capabilities to take out swarms a bit better, most noticeable against a skeleton army or minion horde. She's going to be able to summon skeletons a bit faster too. Currently, she spawns her dudes every 7.5 seconds. With the buff, she'll spawn them faster at 7 seconds now. To be more consistent with the Night Witch, there's a slight nerf. She's not going to spawn the skeletons immediately. Her first wave of skeletons will spawn a bit later. But on the flip side, she's receiving one more buff. They're increasing her health by 5%. It's increasing from 665 to 698. This is a huge buff. She'll be able to tank 1 extra shot from smaller units like archers, minions, skeletons, giant skeleton, ice wizard, guards, and lava pup. And she'll be able to tank 1 extra shot from a P.E.K.K.A., baby dragon, and a wizard. This is a massive buff. She's going to offer a lot of value for 5 elixir. The clone spell is receiving a buff. When you cast the clone spell, it temporarily freezes your units in place for 0.8 seconds. With the new buff, it won't stun your units for as long, so your units and its clones will be ready to engage in battle slightly faster. The battle ram is receiving a tweak. Normally, a bowler, the log, or executioner taking out the ram shield would also splash onto the barbarians. Their attack animation would double dip, dealing double the damage. With a new buff, if you kill the ram itself, it won't splash onto the barbarians. The bats have been tweaked here and there, and like we said in our introduction video, the stats aren't set in stone. The bats have been tweaked and will only spawn 4 bats instead of 5. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more quality OJ.